it's Jen Bengel here from Out of This World Literacy. In episode 58, I introduced the idea of differentiated spelling and compared it to a traditional spelling program. If you'd like to learn more about the differences, check out that episode. Today, we're going to answer one of the most common questions teachers ask when thinking about a differentiated spelling program. Wait, Jen, you said every student has their own list of words each week? How in the world do you administer 30 different spelling tests each week? Well, the answer is pretty simple. To manage all the different word lists, I assign students a spelling buddy. Spelling buddies are the perfect way to help manage a differentiated spelling program and ensure all spellers are working at their instructional levels. Let's get into some of the details of how this works. At the beginning of the year, I administer a spelling benchmark assessment. This is a spelling test of words that I give to the entire class, just like the old school spelling tests you would do every week. I love it because it's quick and I can benchmark all of my spellers in the room at one time. Way quicker than my reading benchmarks. I score the results of the spelling benchmark assessment and determine what level of a speller each student is. So for example, if a student scores a 95 or higher on the benchmark spelling test, I consider them an advanced speller. They're going to be choosing really more advanced words each week when they pick their spelling list. If a student scores a 90 to a 94, I consider them proficient. They are proficient grade level speller. If they score about 80 to an 89, they're a minimal. And if they score below an 80, they are a basic speller. So I can kind of tell right off the bat what kind of spellers I have in my room by doing this benchmark assessment. From there then, I assign students into spelling buddies. I try to place them nearby their buddy's spelling ability level, but they do not need to be at the same level as their buddy. I also take into consideration their personalities, their ability to work with each other, and so on. If I have an odd number of students, I will assign a group of three. That's okay. Or if a student is sick one day and they don't have a buddy, I'll place them with another group or to be with another buddy that day. I like to keep myself free so I can monitor their work and jump in if a partnership needs some extra guidance. So I'll put them in a group of three. Mostly buddies stay the same all year. They can be switched around though if you'd like, but it's not necessary. With a differentiated spelling program, the spelling buddies will be working together all week throughout the year. They do not need to have the same words on their spelling list to work as buddies. In the next few episodes, I'll go over what the buddies do each day of the week, but for now, just know that they will be giving each other their spelling tests at the end of the week. This is so cool because that means everyone is working at their instructional levels, receiving enough challenges in spelling each week to grow, but not too much to feel frustrated. So yes, you can manage 30 different spelling lists using the spelling buddy approach. I've done it for years in the classroom when I was a teacher, and as a literacy coach, I've helped teachers do it as well. I hope the idea of spelling buddies inspires you to think about adapting a differentiated spelling program into your class. If you'd like to check out the spelling benchmark assessment I created and see the interactive spelling programs for grades 2-5, you can visit jenbengelspelling.com. In the next episode, I'll be talking about spelling notebooks. It's been my pleasure chatting with you today. Know that I'm the biggest fan of the work that you and your students are doing in the classroom. If you'd like more teaching tips, you can check out outofthisworldliteracy.com. Until next time, you've got this.